Okay, so in the previous class we have discussed about the different types of performance parameters. Okay, so in the previous class we have discussed about the different types of performance parameter that is used to evaluate the performance of the classification model. Okay, so if you are going to compare the performance of the different types of classification model, then first we will construct this confusion matrix. Okay, so first we will construct this confusion matrix, and then we will find the value of A, B, C and D. Then we will find the value of A, B, C and D. So can you tell me what is the value of A? Anyone, what is the value of A? What is the value of A? Anyone? What is the value of A? That is a true positive. Means what do you mean by that? So the value of A means in the actual class the value is A, and the predicted, the model is also predicting A. So A is nothing but the number of class where the model actual class is also yes and model is also predicting yes. So this is called the correct classification. This is called the correct match. Same like that, B means the actual class is yes but the predicted class is no. This is called the B. So we will find the total number of class where the actual class is A but our model is predicting as a no. This is called the misclassification. Third one, your D. D means the actual class is no and predicted class is also no. Okay, actual class is no and predicted class is also no. Fourth one is actual class is no but the predicted class is yes. So now we are going to take one software. Now assume that this is a software. Software 1. Okay. And the number of class in this software is 1000. Number of this class in the software is 1000. Out of 1000, 900 class belongs to non-faulty class and 100 class belongs to faulty class. Okay. So what is the 900? Non-faulty class and 100 class belongs to faulty class. So we are going to develop one model. We are going to develop one model, and that model is used to predict whether this class is faulty or non-faulty. Okay. So in this case, we got these types of confusion matrix. We draw the confusion matrix. Here is your class equal to yes, no, yes, no. Can we write class equal to yes, no, yes, no? Now assume that. Can you tell me what is the value of this one? What is the value of A plus B? In this case, what is the value of A plus B? Anyone? What is the value of A plus B? What is the value of A plus B? Anyone? What is the value of A plus B? Here, what we are going to predict? Yes means faulty class, no means non-faulty classes. So, what is the total number of non-faulty classes? What is the total number of non-faulty classes? 900. So 900% here, and total number of faulty classes is 100% here. So now we are writing here 60 and we are writing here 40. Can we write 60 correctly classified and 40 non-correctly classified? Because actually this 40 is faulty classes, but our model is saying non-faulty classes. Okay. Now here you will see, now assume that this is 860 and this one is your 40. Can we say? Now, what is the performance of the model? Anyone, what is the performance of the model? In this case, what is the performance of the model? Anyone? how blindly you are saying this is 60%? First, you will calculate the performance of the model. How to calculate the performance? How to calculate the accuracy of the model? The value of diagonal divided by total values. So, what is the value of diagonal? 920 divided by 1000. So, we will get 92% performance. You will get 92% performance. Okay. Now, this is okay. There is no any problem with this one. But now, assume that just can you draw the confusion matrix? Can you draw the confusion matrix? Means you will simply find the value of A, B, C, D. If our model is predicting all classes as a non-faulty. If our model is predicting all classes as a non-faulty. So, can you find what is the value of A, B, C, D? Anyone? What is the value of A, B, C, D if our model is predicting as a all class as a non-faulty? This is your A, B, C, D and this one is your yes, yes, no, no. Can you predict what is the value of A? If our model is predicting all classes as a non-faulty, all classes as a non-faulty, so then what is the value of A? First you will tell me, what is the value of A? Anyone? Our model is predicting all classes as a non-faulty. So this means our actual value is yes and our model is predicting also yes. But our model is predicting all values as a no. So can we write this one equal to 0? Can we write the value of A equal to 0? Because what is the value of A? Actually yes. I mean our model is also predicting yes. Then this is the value of yes. So, in this case, our model is predicting all values as a no. There is no any yes value. So, can we write here 0? Anyone? Can we write here 0? Yes. Then, what is the value of B? What is the value of B? What is the value of B? B means our actual is yes, but our model is predicting no. Means, how many values are there? 100. Can we say how many values are there? 100. Because the total number of faulty class is 100. So, A plus B equal to 100. So, we can we write the value of B equal to 100? What is the value of C? Anyone? What is the value of C? 0. Good. So, the value of C equal to 0 means our actually it's no, but our model is predicting yes. But our model is not predicting any value as yes. So, this one is 0 and this value equal to 900. Then can you find what is the performance of this model? What is the performance of this model? 90%. The performance of this model is 90%. But can we say any use of this model? Because we have developed the model to predict faulty classes. But this model is not able to predict faulty classes. Still we are saying our accuracy is 90%. Still we are seeing our accuracy is 90%. So can we say this is a feasibility model? Can we say this is a feasible model? Can we say? Because our objective is to predict faulty classes, but this model is not predicting faulty classes. This model is simply predicting all classes as a non-faulty. So there is no need to consider the model. There is no need to directly we can say this all the classes are non-faulty. Directly we can say. So there is no need to consider. But according to the accuracy, we are saying 90%. According to the accuracy, we are saying 90%. Means 90% is a good model accuracy. But this is not a good model. So, in this case, accuracy is not a sufficient parameter to judge which is the good model. Based on the accuracy, we cannot decide whether we can use this model or not. So, can you find what is the performance? What is the value of precision? Anyone, what is the value of precision? A divided by A plus C, you will get 0. What is the value of recall? You will get 0. So, what is the value of F measure? You will get 0. So, F measure value is coming 0 here. Based on the F measure value, we can decide whether we can use this model or not. So, not always accuracy is the sufficient parameter to decide which model we will use and which model we will not use. Clear? Any doubt? So, why we will consider F measure? Anyone? Why we will consider F measure? Anyone? F measure is simply, this is the values of first you will find precision and recall, and after that precision and recall, when you will find precision and recall, this is nothing but equal to 2PR divided by R plus P. 2PR divided by R plus P. So this is the value to compute the AF measure. Okay, clear? Okay, now we'll see about the assignment. Okay, so in the assignment we have uploaded 56 different projects. We can use both. We can use accuracy and AF measure both. We always use accuracy and AF measure because accuracy is not only the sufficient parameter to decide which one is the good model. And most of the case, 90% case, we have only considered the accuracy, but that is not a good base. Based on the accuracy, we can easily decide this is a good model, but this is not a good model. So we will consider both accuracy and AF measure, and based on that, we will decide which one is the good model. Which one is the good model? That is different. Okay, so now we will discuss about the assignment. So in the assignment, we have uploaded the 56 different project. 56 different project, and each project containing the 20 different matrix, and the last column basically containing the fault information. Okay, clear? Any doubt in the data? So total number of data is 56. Each data is stored in separate CSV file. Okay. And here for each CSV file, the total number of column is 20. That will represent the features, and the last column basically represent the class. Class means box information. Okay. Now, last column basically containing the values 0, 1, 2, 3 or something like that. Last column basically containing the values, number of bugs present in the class. And how to find these bugs? Based on the historical data. We computed this number of bugs present in the class. Okay. Now, here what we will do? First, we will convert this continuous data to binary data. Means first we will convert this bug class into the two different classes. One is called the faulty classes and second one is called the non-faulty classes. First one is your faulty classes and second one is your non-faulty classes. Faulty classes means at least one bug. And non-faulty classes means zero bug. Clear? At least one bug and non-faulty classes equal to zero bugs. Can we write? Can we say the faulty class is equal to 0 bugs and non-faulty class is equal to at least 1 bugs and non-faulty class is equal to 0 bugs. Simply we will write the program. We will select the last column and we will find the accuracy. Okay, I will show you one demo how to find the Gini split. We are going to find the first value. Just we will see this one. We are going to compute the value of Gini split, but before computing the value of Gini split, first we will compute the Gini of each node. And how to compute the Gini value of each node? We have already known the formula. This is a formula to compute the Gini value of each node. Okay. And before going to find the Gini value of each node, first we will compute this value. Clear? Okay. Now, what we are going to do? Okay, so I am going to write the program in MATLAB. Okay, you can write the similar type of program in Python, R or any language, Java, C, C++, any language. But here I am writing the program in MATLAB. Okay, clear? So here we are going to write the program in MATLAB. Any doubt? Okay. Now, just we will see. Okay, so here you will see we have uploaded the data. This one is your first data. Just you will see. Here we have uploaded the data. Here we have uploaded the data. Just you will see. This is your data, the first data, and the basically the last column basically containing the fault information. Clear? Last column basically containing the fault information. Last column basically containing the fault information. Clear? Any doubt? Any doubt? Okay. Now we are going to write one program to compute Gini split of each feature. To compute the Gini split of each feature. So first we will see, before going to compute the Gini split of the first feature, first we will know, just you will see here, because this is a feature, A is a feature, and we will get only the two value, because we are talking about the binary split. You can also consider the multiple split, but here we are talking about the binary split. Here we are talking about the binary split. So here this one is your yes and this one is your no. Okay, so we will get only the two value of A. We will get only the two value of A. In the case of the continuous value, just we will see. In the case of the continuous value, we will find the threshold value. In case of continuous value, we will find the threshold value. Threshold value means, checkly we are going to find the value of T. Exactly, we are going to find the value T. Okay, so exactly we are going to find the value of T. Okay, exactly we are going to find the value of T. Okay, so now here you will see what we are going to do. This all the values are continuous. Just you will see the first one. This is the first value. First value, all the values are, just you will see, this is the first value, all the values are continuous. So the, what is the best way? Best way you will consider the median value. What is the best way? Best way you will consider the median value. Or if you are going to use some advanced version, then you can use the k-mean clustering technique. You can use the k-mean clustering technique. So what is the use of k-mean clustering technique? First you will focus on here. After that you will ask any question. First you will go one by one. Then you will ask the question how to find what are the values. Simply first you will focus on first feature, how to split this feature into the two different groups. How to split this feature into the two different group, because the, all the feature are continuous value, not the discrete value. Clear? All the values are continuous value. One base thing is we can use the median. We can use the median to find the threshold value, and if the value is greater than median, we can consider as a 1, and if the value is smaller than median, we can consider as a 0. Or we can use the k-mean clustering. So here we are using the k-mean clustering. In the MATLAB, there is one standard function k-means. You can also write your own program, but there you want a standard function k-means. Okay, so we are going to find the cluster. We are going to find the cluster for each feature. Okay, so here we are taking the first feature equal to data of all row comma 1. Because we have stored the data in, we have stored all the data in data variable. Just you will see, this is your data variable, and we have stored all the whole data in data variable. Okay, and this one means we are going to select all row first column. What is that? This is feature. So if you are going to run, just you will see, you will get one here feature. You can use median. You can also use median. You can also, this is the simplest way. Median is the simplest way. You can also use median. But this one is advanced way. Whatever we are going to discuss, this is little bit advanced. Okay. So here what we can see, we got the value of if. Just you will, when you will click this one, you will got the value of if. This is your features one. Just you will see. This one column and first column both are same. This is 11, 14, 3, 12. And this value is also 11, 14, 3, 12. Okay. Now we are going to apply the k-mean clustering. And we will write here A comma B equal to K means if comma 2. So we are going to divide the whole data into the two different groups, that is called 1 and 2. So when you will run this program, just you will see, you will get the value of A and B. Just you will see, this is A value of. So value of A only 1 and 2. Just you will see, this value is only 1 and 2. You will get only 1 and 2. You will get only 1 and 2. Just you will see. You will get only 1 and 2. Or instead of using k-mean clustering, you can also use median. Median of is equal to ME median of S. Just you will learn. Okay. So here we are going to use median because most of the students are interested for median. So here we are going to use median. Okay. So just we'll see. This is your median. Median equal to 8. Means if the value is greater than median, we will consider 1. If the value is smaller than median, we will consider as a 0. Okay. So here we are going to write, simply we are going to write the value of theta equal to double where f greater than equal to mf. Okay, just try to understand what I am doing here. Just you try to understand. Here this is just like one type of operator, greater than equal to. If this condition is true, it will return true. Return true means it will return boolean value 1 or 0. Means if the condition is true, it will return 1. If the condition is false, it will return 0. Okay, but that will return the boolean value. Because this is a condition. That's why here we are writing double to convert the boolean value to integer value. To convert the boolean value to integer value. So now here we will see the value of f you will get here. Just you will see. Now we will see. So the value of f is 1100. So can we say this is a discrete value? Can we say this is a discrete value? Anyone? Can we say this one is discrete value? Yes, we can say. So now we will apply the same procedure for all the 20 value. So there is one concept called for loop. So can we apply the for loop here? Can we write for I equal to 1 to 20, for I equal to 1 to 20, and here we will write end, and first one we will write here I. So if we are writing I, means if the value of I equal to 1, which feature we are going to select? If the value of I equal to 1, we are selecting the first column. Value of I equal to 2, we are selecting the second column. Value of I equal to 3, we are selecting the third column. Value of I equal to 4, we are selecting the fourth column. So same like that, we are going to select the all the 20 columns, all the 20 features. Okay. And now after that, we will find the median value of each feature. And then we will store in the modified data, this is called the discrete data. 1, 2, the length of the data is 125, comma I equal to F. Can we write? So after that, when you will run this program, you will get the modified data. You will get the modified data, and modified data only contain the discrete value. Can we say, just we are going to run this program? Yes. So just you will see here, here you will get modified data, and modified data only contain the two value 1 and 0. Only containing the two value 1 and 0. Just you will see. Only containing the two values 1 and 0. Clear? Up to here, clear? So what is the purpose of this code? What is the purpose of this code? Anyone, what is the purpose of this code? Anyone, what is the purpose of this code? Converting continuous value to discrete value. Converting continuous value to discrete value. Okay. Now, after that, we are going to compute the value of Gini split. We are going to compute the value of Gini split. Just you will see. So, if you are going to compute the value of Gini split, first you will compute the value of Gini. First you will compute the value of Gini, and after that you can compute the value of Gini split. Okay. So, here we are going to write one program. That program is used to compute the Gini value of node. That program is used to compute the Gini value of this node. Okay. So just you will see. Just you will focus here. In the code, it is given like the information gain. So you will write the similar types of program for information. But here we are writing for Gini split. Here we are writing for Gini split. The same types of program you will write for the information gain. Okay. So now we are going to define one function. Just you will see, we are going to define one function, and the name of this function is Gini value. Gini value, and it will take the two values, because in the Gini value we need the values for which value we are going to compute the Gini value. So just you will see here, just you will see in the code here you will see. So in the Gini value we need the how many sample belongs to faulty classes and how many samples belongs to non-faulty classes. Just you will see the Gini value, how to compute the Gini value. We only send the two value. One is the number of sample belongs to faulty classes and number of samples belongs to non-faulty classes. Okay, so here we are going to pass one value, fault information. Here we are going to pass one value, fault information. Okay, we are going to pass one value, fault information. So here first we will find how many values are 0 and how many values are greater than 0. Because we have considered 0 means non-faulty classes and greater than 0 means faulty classes. Can we say anyone? Can we say 0 means faulty class, non-faulty classes and greater than 0? We are not saying greater than equal to. We are saying only greater than means 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So there is one function called find. Find basically used to find the index. Find the index. So here we are writing in equal to find where fault info equal to 0. So in equal to nothing but we are writing the fault info equal to 0. What do you mean by that? It will compute the index of those lines where the fault information equal to 0. Where the fault information equal to 0. Okay. And now after that we will find what is the number of fault, number of non-faulty classes equal to length of in. Length of in basically used to compute, length of in basically used to compute the length of this matrix. The length of this matrix means basically compute the length of index. How many values are there? And what do you mean by length of index? Anyone? What do you mean by length of index? Anyone? What do you mean by length of index? Simply count. So we are counting the number of, we are counting the number of non-faulty classes. We are counting the number of non-faulty classes. So what is the number of faulty classes? So can we write the number of faulty class equal to length of fault info minus length of NO, sorry, NONF is already the length. So we will write NONF. NF. Can we write NONF? Can we write? Can we write the faulty information, number of faulty information equal to NONF? Now after that, what we are going to compute? Just you will see here. After that, we will compute the probability. What is the probability of C1 and what is the probability of C2? Okay, so same thing we are will write, the probability of NONF equal to, can we write NONF divided by length of fault information? Can we write? This is the probability value of none. What is the probability value? The number of sample belongs to non-faulty classes divided by total number of sample. So can we write this value? Anyone, can we write? If you have any doubt, just you will ask. If you have any doubt, then simply you will ask. So we can simply will write this one. Same like that, what is the probability of number of faulty classes equal to NOF divided by length of fault information. Clear? Just to see why you are going advanced. Here up to Amit Kumar, here up to it is clear. Any doubt? Up to here, any doubt? Just you will focus up to here. I will discuss what is the how to handle the continuous value and non-continuous value. How to handle, I will discuss. But now currently we will focus up to here. Any doubt? Because just try to think, here we have already handled the continuous value. Just you will see what we are taking here, IN equal to 0, and what is the NO, NF, anyone? Number of faulty classes. Here, what we are counting? Try to think what we are going to count. Anyone, what is the NO, NF? We are counting those values where the values of bugs greater than 0. Here, the value of bugs greater than 0. So, can we say we have already created the discrete value? Because we are counting the first one, we are counting the number of value equal to 0, and second one, we are counting the number of values greater than 0. Greater than 0. So, in both the cases, we will get the same value. So, here we have already handled the continuous to discrete. Here we have already handled the continuous to discrete. Okay, so now here we have already computed the probability value. After computing the probability value, now we will see the formula. How to compute the Gini value? 1 minus probability square minus probability square. So, can we write the Gini value equal to 1 minus PNONF dot square minus PNOF dot square. Can we write? Can we write? So, this is a Gini value and we will return the Gini value, G-I-N-I, Gini value. We will return the Gini value. So, this function is basically used to compute the Gini value. So, we will write this value is your Gini value. Clear? So, we have created one function, Gini value, that is basically used to compute the Gini value. That is basically used to compute the Gini value of any model, any node. That is used to compute the Gini value of any node. After finding the Gini value, now we will apply this one to compute the Gini split value. This one to compute the Gini split value. Okay. So, after that we will use this one to compute the Gini split value. So, again we will create one more function. Just we will see, we are going to create one more function. And this function is used to compute Gini split value, and it will take how many arguments? Just will think, it will take how many arguments? So, it will take the first, it will take the values, the whole data, whole feature data, it will take the whole feature data and also the fault information. So, you need to value the whole feature data and also the fault information value. So, here we are going to pass the feature value and bugs. Can we write? So, here we are going to pass the feature value and bugs. Can we write? Anyone, can we write? So, this is just like one type of function. We are going to compute the function. Bugs is a one type of variable. Bugs is a one type of variable. This is nothing. One type of variable. Where we will pass the last column. Here we will pass the last column. Clear? Where we will pass the last column. Okay. Okay. Before that, we have already known that each feature has how many value, how many unique value? Anyone? Each feature has how many unique value? 2. What is the value? 0 and 1. What is the value? 0 and 1. So, now we are going to find the index of 0 equal to find where f equal to 0 and index of 1 equal to find where f equal to 1. Can we write? Can we write this one? We are going to find the index. We are going to find the total number of index where the value is equal to 1 and we are going to find the total number of index where value equal to 0. This is just like one function. So, this function we are passing the feature and we are passing the bug information, that is called the last column. Okay. Now, in index 0, what is the bugs value? We are writing the in the index 0, what the bugs value? So, we are writing bugs, comma, index 0. So, what is the index 0 bugs? Basically, it will contain the, what is the bugs information in this index? What is the bug information in this index? Because just we will think here, what we are going to do, just we will see. here when the value equal to yes, we are going to find what is the value of C0 and C1. What is the value of C0 and C1? Means in place of yes, in place of 0, first we will find what is the value of this last column. What is the value of this bug? Bug means fault information, whether 0 or 1. Okay. Now, this one. So, we will call this function Gini value. This function is basically used to compute the Gini split of this node. So, we are going to find the Gini split of 0th node. Simply, we are right. Equal to, we will pass this value. Same thing we will write for 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. Clear? Here there is no need to take the loop because we have already know there are only the two values. Bug is only the column, just like C. You will see here we are writing BUGS box equal to 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 2 1 0 0. Now assume that, sorry, this is a last column. Bug is a last column, just like C here. This is a bug information. Now assume that for this one 1 0. Now assume that this is your, now assume that, try to think, now assume that for feature 1, these are the index, we are writing for feature 1, these are the index 1, 3, 4 and 5. These are the index, just try to think, these are the index where the feature 1 value equal to 0. These are the index where the feature 1 value equal to 0. So now we are going to find what is the bug information of this index. So we will write bug of F1. Just you will see, this is a bug information. So what do you mean by that? What is the value of C1 and C2? Just you will see, what is the value of C1 and C2? C0 and C1. C0 non-faulty classes. So in this case, what is the value? 3. And what is the value of this one? 1. So same that we are doing here. Clear? Now, after that, we will compute the value of Gini split. So we are writing the GS. Gini split equal to, what is the value? First one, what is the value of Gini split? Anyone? The number of samples belongs to node 1. So what is the number of samples belongs to node 1? The length of this index. Can we write? So the length of this index. So we will simply write the length of IN0 divided by length of F. Can we write? Into, because we will write here, better to write in the bracket, into, can we write the Gini V0, Gini value V0, plus the same thing we will write here, clear? Any doubt? So can we write here? So what we are writing, the length of IN0. Length of IN0 means this value. And after that we are writing the length of IN1 divided by this one. And we are multiplying with the Gini value. And here we will return the Gini split value. And the name of this function is, we will say with clear. Up to here, clear? No any doubt? This is just like one function. We have created one function to count this value. Clear? Okay. Now, after that, we have already computed this data. Now, we will run how many times? 20 times. So, we write for I equal to 1 to 20. For I equal to 1 to 20. And we are going to calculate the Gini split. So, how many values will return? It will return the one value for each one. So we will write the Gini split value of I equal to, we will call this function we will call this function, and here we will pass the value m data of all comma I, and what is the bug information? M data of all comma 21, or you can also write int. Int means last column. So can we write this is the last one? This one is always constant. This is your last value. That is either you will write m data all column all row comma 21, or you can also write all row comma int. Okay. Sorry, m data does not contain bug information. Right. M data does not contain bug information. The data contain bug information. So can we write? Thank you. Here m data does not contain bug information. Data containing bug information. Can we write here data? Anyone? Can we write? Okay. So now we are going to run this program, because this program we have already run. So we will simply write here. We are going to comment this one, and we are going to write this one. So here you will see we got the value of Gini split value. So this is a Gini split value for all the features. Just we will say this is a Gini split value for all the features. Last one there is no need to discuss, right? Last one there is no need to, because we have already considered 0 as a non-faulty class and greater than 0 as a faulty class. So we are going to convert two cases. So there is no need to write. Either you will write or not write, both cases you will get the same answer. Okay. So clear. So any doubt in finding the Gini split? Any doubt here? Any doubt? Some case it is coming not a number. Some case it is coming not a number, because it is coming 0 divided by 0. So that's why it will come not a number. So in this case we can replace by 0. Now assume that all the classes belong to what? Now assume that all the values are constant. In this case, what is the problem? In the third column, all the values are 1 or all the values are 0. That's why it is coming this type of problem. Clear? Just we will see why it is coming problem in the third case. We are writing m data of all column comma 3. I think all the values are coming 1 here. Just we will see all the values are coming here 1 here. Then simply find minimum of m data of all column comma 3 1. So all the values are 1 here. Just you will see all the values are 1 here, that's why it is coming not a number. Clear? So any doubt? If you have any doubt, then again I will explain this one. Okay, this one I think better to explain here. It will become very easy. Now here you will see what we are doing here. Just try to see what we are going to do here. Just we'll see. This is our fault data. Now assume that this is our fault data. Okay. Just we'll see what we are doing here. This is a last column basically containing the fault information. Okay. And these are the features. Okay. First, what we are doing? First, we are finding the median of each feature. First, we are finding the median of each feature. Now assume that the And now after that we are comparing with the each value. If the m value is greater than this one, then we will write 1, otherwise we will write 0. Okay. So when after this step, you will get all the values as a discrete. Clear? Up to here any doubt? Up to here any doubt? No. Okay. Now, after that what we are doing, we are defining one function. We are defining one function. In this function we are going to pass, we assume that the fault information present at this node. We are going to assume what are the fault information present at this node in 1. Okay. So now assume that this fault information we have saved in F. Okay. So after that, what is the step? We will compute the value of C0 and C1. What is the C0? The number of non-faulty classes and the number of faulty classes. So here simply we are counting 0. Simply we are counting 0, that will represent the number of non-faulty classes, and after that simply we are counting greater than 0, that will represent the faulty classes. So this function name is called the Gini value. Guinea value. Clear? Up to here, any doubt? Up to here, any doubt? No. Okay. After that, what is the step? After that, our objective is to find this value. What value it will send to this node and what fault value it will send to this node. So, how to decide? First, we will take the feature. So, this is a feature. Feature value. What is the possible value of feature? 1 or 0. Can we say 1 or 0? Now, we are going to find out where we are getting this 1 and 0. Now, assume that here we are writing 1. So, we will get 1 and 2 place. So, that is called the index. So, we are going to find the index where we are getting 1 values, 1 and 5. In place of 1 and 5, what is the value of this feature? Fault. What is the value of this fault? We will write like that. If equal to fault 1 and comma 5. So, here it will go to the fault information. After that, we are going to find where the value are equal to 0. So, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, again, we will find the fault information. After that, we will calculate the value. Clear? Any doubt? Simply, we will also calculate the information gain. Just you will see. Simply, we will change one place and we will compute the information gain. Just you will see here. By the formula of information gain. So, instead of taking this one, we will take the log value. Just you will see. We will take the log value. Here you will see. We will take the log value and we will compute the entropy equal to minus Pj by Ta into log value. For each node, we will compute this value. And after that, we will use this function called entropy equal to entropy of the parent node minus this one. Entropy of the parent node minus this one. Clear? So, how to modify this code? Just we will see. How to modify this code to get the entropy value. Now, you will see. How to modify. So, where we will modify this code? Here. So, first you will check. Just we will see here. First we will check. Log 2 in MATLAB. So, we can simply write log 2. Just we will see if you are going to check this log 2 is working or not. So, we will simply write log 2, 2. What is the value it will come? Anyone? What is the value of log 2, 2? Log 2 base 2, 1. Just you will see. Means this function is working fine. Can we say this function is working fine? Can we say? Clear. Okay. Now, here you will see, we will only modify it here. We have already calculated the probability value. Just you will see. We have already calculated the probability value and how to calculate the entropy at the specific node. Just you will see, entropy equal to minus P by J into log 2 base P by J. And we will simply write the summation. So, can we write here the, we are writing the same value. This is a variable name. So, we are writing the Gini value equal to minus probability of NONF into log 2 probability of NONF. Clear? Minus probability of NOF into bracket log 2 probability of NOF. Clear? So, now in this case it will compute the entropy at a specific node. Just you will see, we are taking the same value. It will compute the entropy value. Just you will see, it will compute the entropy value. Okay, and after that, if you are going to compute the information gain, that is the entropy of the parent node minus entropy of the summation of entropy of the child node. So, now we will go to this place and first we will compute the what is the entropy of parent node. So, we are going to compute the entropy of parent node equal to, simply we will call this function and we will pass the bug information. We will pass the whole bug information. We will pass the whole bug information and this value we have already computed. This one is your Gini value 0 and Gini value 1. And based on that, we have already computed this value. Just we will see. The second value is same like that, ni by n into entropy of I. That is nothing but this one ga. We have already computed. So what is the final value? The final entropy value, information gain equal to, info gain equal to, can we write ENP, entropy minus GS. Can we write? And we will go and store here, we will return I information gain. So here we will write IF information, IF GM, INFG. Okay. So INFG. Save and we will run this one. Now we will see. See, this is information gain. This is called the reusability. We are using the previous code. We are using the previous code. We are modifying slightly and we will get the answer. Which one? Gini value M. Where we are talking about? So we have modified this code. Now this value is used to compute the entropy. Now this function is used to compute entropy. Previously we have used this function to calculate Gini split. But now we have modified this function here to compute entropy. This is also concept of reusability. Where we have used twice. You are talking about where? In the last line. Here we have used it twice. Clear? Any doubt? How to compute? So same way we will compute for every project. Same way we will compute for every project. Every project. So similar like that. This program similar like that. What we will write? For j equal to 1 to 56. And simply we will write this code. Simple like that. First we will install this data. And here we... Sorry. Simple we will write. Here some commands. Simple we will write for k equal to 1 to 56 and within a half an hour you can write this program. For k equal to 1 to 56, this program will run 56 times and you will get the values. You will get the values. Any doubt? Simply we will store the data here. First we will store the whole data into the data value and after that we will run this program, you will get the values. After that we will run this program, you will get the values. Just we will copy from here because we are doing the online. Project is already completed. I have already given you the whole code. This will work for 15 minutes, we will get the whole value. Maximum 15 minutes. It will take maximum 15 minutes to find the value of information gain and everything. Yes, attribute with the highest information gain we will consider as the best attribute. Decision tree will check. In the MATLAB there is one function called fit tree. In MATLAB there is one function called fit tree. So where we will pass the input data and we will get the output data. Clear? So now we will take 5 minute break and after that we will start association rule. After that we will start the new topic called association rule. Here you can also use the visualization technique. Just you will see here we can also use the visualization technique. There are different types of method are there. So as for example now assume that just you will see here this is your data just you will see and we are going to develop the box plot diagram. So simply you can write box plot data of all comma 1. Just you will see. So this will create the box plot diagram. You will get this types of box plot diagram for data 1. If you want to create for whole data, you can write this one in box plot diagram for whole data. You can simply write data. It will create the box plot diagram for whole data. Just you will see. So this is just like one. MATLAB is a good tool for the data mining. Data loading you can directly, if you are writing in the MATLAB, I will give you one code where you can directly use for the data mining. I think there even code is there. So you can use this code. You can use this code for downloading the CSV file. You can use this code to downloading the CSV file. I have given you the whole code. Simply will write for j equal to 1 to 56, CSV file equal to strcat number 2 to something dot CSV, and you will run this program. I think there is something problem here, otherwise I will show you the how to run this program. And this one here I will upload, because this is there any way to upload the data. Okay, just I will one time I will try here, and this one, where is the data? Just 1 second. Data extract to data. I will try to check whether it is working or not. So we are taking here 15 data. Now assume that we are taking here 15 data. No, it's not coming. Yes, it is coming. I think I will check data. Okay, so you will see here. You will see. So here it is coming 1 to 10. This is a data 1 to 10 CSV file. Now we are going to write the same program. Just you will see. 1 to 10, 1 to 10, 1 to 10, so here we are writing the CSV file number to string k. k.csv, and after that we are going to store this one in data. Data equal to csv.read, and here whatever the values it will come, we are going to store this value in k comma I. Now you'll see, I think it will work. Okay, there is something problem. Okay. There is something problem is coming here. Simply m data equal to 0. Slightly we have to change here, and here we will write size of data comma 1. So I think now it, yeah, so it is working. Just you will see. Just you will see, it is working here. You will see it is working here. So now we will see the value. We have already computed the values for the 10, means 10 project. Just you will see, this is a value for the 10 project. Just you will see, this is a value for the 10 project and 20 different matrix. So we can run this program to get this value. same like that, simply we will write here 56 and we will run this. So what we are doing here, just you will see, first we are writing number to string k dot csv. So now in the first, when the value of k equal to 1, what is the value, what is the name of the csv file? When the value of k equal to 1, what is the name of the csv file? Can we say 1.csv? Okay, and after that we are loading this CSV, we are reading this CSV file and we are loading the data in the data file. Can we say? So in the first case, when the k equal to 1, the data belongs to first project. K equal to 2, data belongs to second project. K equal to 3, data belongs to third project. K equal to 4, data belongs to fourth project. Same like that. And for each project we are writing, okay, just to take the, I will take 5 minute break just to go through this program. If you have any doubt, if you have any doubt, just you will ask the question. CSV file I have already uploaded. First go and check the assignment. CSV file I have already uploaded. Now you will see, this is the whole program I have uploaded. Okay, so 5 minute break and after that we will start.